Thank you.
I've always known about Norah's voice.
And we finally awake and walk into the sunny day.
I think the album is kind of a little stories in a big picture. The songs are all little pieces and scenes.
They're all broken, they're for
all,
sure.
Yeah, they're all busted up pretty bad.
I can't believe it's happening now.
Ooh. When doing the parts for their own stuff, we were really stressing over who to get for a female vocal. Norah was the first person we went to. I didn't know Norah, so I just went to her apartment and played her some music and said pretty please, and she just said yes.
We had a fun time in the studio and we hung out after Rome, and so I feel like we got to be friends, and I really loved working with Brian, and I was trying to figure out my next record, and so I asked him if he would be interested in producing for me. His idea was to write together and do it kind of from the ground up that way. Both of us wanted to just try this, and neither of us had any pressure or agenda. I feel like I was pretty open to whatever happened and excited to just sort of explore some things.
I just remember doing it for fun, and then when we were done, the entire record got way darker.
Yeah, after that song.
We did that song, and it was almost a mistake. Like, we weren't trying to make a record like this, were we? It was like, no. But it's a cool song, but let's go, let's, and it gave us more focus for the rest of the album as to what kind of record we were trying to make.
Yeah, that's true.
Don't you miss the good old days when you let me misbehave?
This one started with the two of us. I was playing drums and you were playing bass.
Yeah.
We just were just in there with nothing, just jamming pretty much. Even I don't like that word, but that's what we were doing. We just started playing together in the room, just the two of us. We didn't have anybody else in the studio really at the time. And we just started playing together and coming up with something with the feel. And then once we did that, we went in and started trying to find melodies and stuff.
Yeah, I would have never come up with a song with bass because I don't play bass. So it was a very different way for me to go into a song. But it was great because it's all about the groove.
It was good to be able to write with Norah. I think that it's always more, to me, get better stuff kind of writing with people and bouncing stuff back and forth. And whenever we would hang out and talk about, you know, we're gonna do this record, this, that, whatever, we knew that we could go in and come up with stuff from scratch together.
Tonight they want revenge. Beautiful soldiers in their beds, making love.
The album is definitely from Norah's perspective, is Norah's album, and it's from her perspective. It's just, I get to kind of be there and go, wow, because this is what happens. This is what women think sometimes. And sometimes every once in a while, I get to throw something in there of what I wish a woman would think, and she'll sing it. And
it's like I'm a puppet.
Yeah, but not really.
Yeah. With the weapons in their hands and their eyes closed as they stand, can they end it all tonight?
To be able to kind of talk to each other in conversation through lyrics in a way. It seemed to be able to do that.
It was great because I remember in the beginning, that first week we worked together, we had pretty finished songs, but the lyrics were not finished or fleshed out. And I remember thinking, well, that's the hardest part of songwriting for me. So I was a little bit worried, but he was like, no, we'll get that.
Won't you take me away from here? So I'm
sing a little differently on this record because I think Brian likes me when I sing soft. I was just finding what sounded good on the songs and trying to please him, mostly.
I have no problem with women trying to please me. It's fine. It's not an issue.
Oh, Miriam. People react differently to Miriam. Some people get uncomfortable. And I'll keep saying. And some people get excited. Until you die. And some people get angry.
I had said to her, I have a couple of things, and then she said, well, I have this one. And she started playing Miriam. And yeah, it was pretty instant for me too. I mean, just like I see other people react to the song, I was the same way when I first heard it, so I like how dark it is.
Well, so the first time I came out to LA to work with Brian in his studio, I noticed all these Russ Meyer posters that he has in the studio, which are awesome. There's this one, the Mudhoney poster, was right over the couch where I sat every day. And so I always was looking at it and thinking, that's so cool. I want my hair to look like that. I want to look like her, you know? I remember staring at that poster the whole time we made the record. And so then we were just kind of talking about it. And I said, what do you think if I tried to just recreate the poster for the cover? Because it's a great visual. Songs.
There's a lot of songs that sound like when they first come on, they sound like the beginning of the album. By the time they end, they sound like the end of the album, but it's just a song.
I mean, I love the way the sounds are, and I love all the textures and all the things I never have tried before. For me, that was really exciting, all the sounds he gets.